For those of you who have a table with staggered wheels on the Ender 3, the problem with this is that these two are stationary and these two have the eccentric adjustments. You can back this one off and get these three to ride pretty smoothly back and forth. But as soon as you try to bring this one in to where this wheel is carrying some of the load, it throws out this other adjustment. The CR10 has the wheels directly opposite each other, and that's what I intend to do with this. The reason these two wheels are located where they are, in order for this table to come forward, this wheel has to be back here because the wheel itself is hitting this bracket. It is this bracket that the wheel hits when the carriage comes all the way forward. And all the way back here in the back, this wheel is hitting the bracket for the Y-axis stepper motor. I'm going to change this bracket, move this end-stop micro switch further to the rear. I have a new bracket that will be on Thingiverse. I'm going to move this wheel back here directly opposite this one that's fixed. And I'm going to move this fixed one up here directly opposite this eccentric. I'm going to put the new bracket over here on this side, and there will no longer be anything in the way of these wheels. I'm going to take the carriage off of here, and I'm going to take the stepper motor off the other end. And this has been cut on a chop saw or whatever, and this edge right here is very sharp. You need to take a jeweler's file or an X-Acto knife and trim on this. Your timing belt runs through the center of this and comes around the turnaround pulley and returns up here to the carriage. And so that belt is coming very close to this edge. It's just a good idea to go ahead and smooth out all these edges while we have a chance to do it. The existing bracket is mounted in an L pattern to the 2040 extrusion. And this is the 8mm bolt that goes through there for the turnaround pulley. My bracket's going to be this way, and the alignment of that 8mm bolt is exactly the same. And I verify that the offset is exactly the same by putting some bolts in here. This bracket's made out of steel. The original was made out of aluminum. These are exactly the same thickness. And this was cut out on a CNC water jet. A picture of the dimensions of this and the DXF file will be on Thingiverse. The new bracket's in place. These have been drilled, and that's quite easy to adjust. Nothing has been destroyed here. We still have the original bracket, and the holes are in the plate as they were before. You can always go back to what it was, but this is easier to adjust, and I don't feel any clunking going back and forth. Where the original plate was like this, this plate is now down here, clears the wheels. This can come all the way forward. I might have gone a little overboard with this one way back here. But this is steel, the original is aluminum, and I know this is stronger than that. This is my bracket for the Y end stop. It gives a lot of adjustment. And I have that set up to where the wheel hits the micro switch. It's hitting it right there. And there's still that much more travel until it hits this bracket for the stepper. Once the hotbed is back on here, go to the home position. I can verify where this needs to be.